हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माहुल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवलिया जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज मंडफिया चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम। व्हाट इज ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम? एक्चुअली इट इज़ एन एरिया वेयर द वेजिटेशन इज मेनली डोमिनेटेड बाय ग्रासेस एंड अदर हर्बेशियस प्लांट्स दैट आर नॉन वुडी। एंड ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज ट्रांजिशनल landscape because this ecosystem is dominated by the grass with few or no trees in the area and where there is not enough for a forest and too much of forest. They are known by different names in different regions of world. Like in Europe and Asia, grassland are known as steppes. In South America, they are known as pampas. In South Africa, there are welds. And in Australia, grassland ecosystem is known by the name of downs. What are the characteristics of grassland ecosystem? Grassland ecosystem is characterized by very limited annual rainfall. And there is a dry climate throughout the year. Maybe there are lack of nutrients in the soil. And grasslands are prone to drought and a certain precipitation. One can see frequent fire due to semi-arid climate and flash lighting. And there is a poor vegetation growth, which are dominated by grasses. And grasslands are home for huge variety of animal species. These are the basic characteristics of grassland, but these characteristics vary from one grassland to another as well. So, first of all, I'll explain components of grassland ecosystem. So, there are mainly two components, abiotic and biotic. Abiotic components are non-living thing components and they are mainly consist of carbon, hydrogen, sulfur, nitrogen and phosphorus. While biotic components are living components. They may be of three types, that is producers, consumers and decomposers. Producers are the grasses like Cynodon, Digitaria, Desmodium, Cetaria. And if herbs and shrubs present, they also contribute to the primary production of food. So these are producers. They form food for the other level of components like consumers and primary, secondary and tertiary consumers. Now consumers. Consumers are of three levels in grassland. First is primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary consumers feed directly from the grasses and these animals include herbivores like cows, buffaloes, goats, rabbits, mouse and also insects, termites, centipede, millipedes, etc. Now secondary consumers. These consumers are the carnivorous animal like snakes, lizard, jackal, foxes, frog, and they primarily feed on the primary consumers. They are dependent on primary consumers for their food. Now tertiary consumers. It includes hawk, eagles and vultures which prey upon secondary and primary consumers. So this is about consumer. Now decomposers. The organic matter of the grassland is decomposed by microbes like actinomycetes, fungi like mucor, aspergillus, rhizopus, penicillium and cladosporium, and aerobic and anaerobic soil bacteria. Actually, decomposers release the mineral back into the soil and thus help in making soil fertile. So these are biotic components, which includes producers, consumers and decomposers. Now there are mainly six types of grasslands all over the world. So first is tropical grassland, second temperate grassland, third flooded grassland, fourth tundra grassland, then mountain grassland, and then xeric और डेजर्ट ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम। फर्स्ट, ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम। दीज ग्रासलैंड्स आर फाउंड इन ट्रॉपिकल रीजन्स ऑफ अर्थ दैट इज नियर रेन फॉरेस्ट। क्लाइमेट ऑफ दिस इकोसिस्टम इज वार्म थ्रू आउट द ईयर एंड इट इज कैरेक्टराइज बाय मेनली टू सीजन्स दैट इज रेनी एंड ड्राई। टेम्परेचर इन ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड वेराइज बिटवीन 21 to 26 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड द प्रेसिपिटेशन दैट इज रेन ड्यूरिंग द रेनी सीजन इन ट्रॉपिकल ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम ranges from 50 to 130 centimeters. In tropical grassland ecosystem, soil is quite poor in terms of fertility. Why? They lack nutrients. Tropical grassland ecosystem have tall grasses with scattered shrubs and stunted trees. They are home to various species of animals like zebras, antelopes and giraffe. Example of tropical grassland ecosystem is savanna grassland. Now, temperate grassland ecosystem. These grasslands found in temperate region of earth. It receives an annual rainfall of up to 25 to 75 centimeter. Here, temperature varies a lot throughout the year. In summer season, it becomes too hot, up to 38 degrees Celsius. While in winter season, it becomes minus 40 degrees Celsius and make this ecosystem too cold. This grassland are quite rich in nutrient content in soil. Nutrient-rich soil improves the fertility of soil and makes this grassland perfect for farming. And this is the reason why more than 50% of temperate prairies grassland have been used for farming purposes. Here, grasses are taller as compared to tropical grassland. And these provide shelter to wide variety of wild animals. Example of temperate grassland ecosystem is North American prairies. Now, flooded grassland ecosystem. It is characterized by presence of water throughout the year. And there is a huge variety of plant that grow in water and there is a huge variety of migratory birds. There are resident birds also present, but mainly there are migratory birds which comes from another place and spend their part of life here. Example of these type of grassland is Florida's Everglades. Now, tundra grassland ecosystem. This grassland is also known as polar grasslands. They are found in Arctic polar region. They are located in higher altitudes to subarctic regions. They are characterized by severe cold and strong winds along with ice and snow. They experience a very, very short growing season. Here you can observe Arctic wolf, Arctic fox, and there is huge grass fields and shrub in between. So this is tundra grassland ecosystem. Now, mountain grassland ecosystem. Mountain means higher altitude. These grasslands are found on higher altitude above the tree line. These plants found in mountain plants found in mountain grassland are unique structure with presence of disc-like formation and they are full of fur and waxy surface area. Example of mountain grassland ecosystem is Northern Andes. Now, xeric or desert grassland ecosystem. They are situated on the outskirts of desert lowland. And they are very, very poor in terms of precipitation because they receive very low rainfall. And this type of grassland is the hottest and driest grassland ecosystem present on अर्थ. सो दिस इज द ड्राइएस्ट वन. सो टुडे आई एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज ग्रासलैंड इकोसिस्टम एंड आई गेव डिफरेंट नेम्स. दे आर नोन बाय डिफरेंट नेम्स इन डिफरेंट रीजन्स ऑफ वर्ल्ड. देन आई एक्सप्लेन सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्रासलैंड विच आर कॉमन बट दे मे वेरी फ्रॉम वन ग्रासलैंड टू अनादर. Now, then I explain components of grassland ecosystem, which include abiotic components and biotic components. And again, biotic components are of three types, that is producers, consumers, and decomposers. Consumers are again of three types, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Then I explain six types of grassland. First, I explain tropical grassland ecosystem, example, savanna. Then temperate grassland ecosystem, example North American prairies. There is a difference between tropical and temperate grassland ecosystem. Here grasses are taller, but in tropical grasses are short. In tropical there is same temperature throughout the year, that is it is warm throughout the year, but temperate varies a lot throughout the year. In summer it becomes hot up to 38 degrees Celsius, and in winter it becomes too cold up to minus 40 degrees Celsius. Example of temperate grassland ecosystem is North American prairies. These are also known as for farming. Then flooded grassland ecosystem, in which a whole year one can observe water, and there are aquatic plants and aquatic animals. Example of flooded grassland ecosystem is Florida Everglades. Then tundra, they are also known as polo grassland, and they are characterized by severe cold and strong wind with snow and ice. Then mountain, which are present on high altitude, that is above tree line. An example of mountain grassland ecosystem is northern Andes. And desert grassland ecosystem, they are like, they have a characteristic like desert, means they are hottest and driest, and they are poor in terms of precipitation because they receive very low rainfall. A desert grassland ecosystem are also known as xeric. Xeric means they're like, they have a characteristics of xerophytic condition. Xerophytic means dry and hot characters of the place. So this is all about types of grassland. Thank you.